You ready?
Yeah.
Good evening. Welcome to our June 3rd special meeting. Would everybody please stand for the pledge? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation,
under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, a couple of time-sensitive issues, so we've called a special meeting. First of all, we have noticed, as an announcement, Rhinecliff Fire Department, Hillside Fire Department, and the Village Fire Department, along with us and our Emergency Services Coordinator and Sandy Williams, the former County EMS head, that we are going to have a joint meeting on the 23rd of June at 6 to discuss next steps for the dissolution of our Fire Protection District. We have confirmation from everyone except the Village yet. We're still working on that. So we'll keep you posted. Does anybody else have any other announcements? Okay, I'd like to make a motion for Resolution 2015-131, Extension of Royal Karting Transfer Station Contract. May I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion?
This has three renewals periods at our option, and it runs to 2027. John has put in his tickler file the dates by which we have to give notice, and it continues if we give that notice by those three dates. We can terminate the contract on 90 days notice, and they're taking over the cost of the electric.
Great. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So moved. I will make a motion for Resolution 2015-140, acceptance of the bid for removal and disposal of asbestos in the Town Hall Boiler Utility Room. May I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion?
As you can see, we're proposing to go with a low bidder at $21,768. We met this morning with both the low bidder and the project manager, who we've already hired, and then we met with the employees. The schedule will be that they're going to start work on the Monday the 15th, 2 days of preparation. They're going to put up a wall to shield off the electric, so we'll be able to keep the electric on. The asbestos will be removed on Wednesday the 17th. They are hopeful, and it'll be a long day for them, that they can get all of it out in one day. Early Thursday morning, the project monitor will come in, do air samples, and we'll let the asbestos company and us know whether the air is clear by hopefully around midday on Thursday. And then if so, the abatement company will take down its partitions and be out of here Friday. Elizabeth, you asked if they're gonna stay up here. Yes, they'll stay up here. Their employees come from the city. They'll stay in a hotel here. I've checked references. Alan has checked references, and Alan's been with me on all the meetings. The references are good.
Can we entertain closing Town Hall on Wednesday into Thursday?
Well, we certainly can entertain it. What the feeling was that we should at least close off the basement on Wednesday, and Thursday. And I'm sending a email to the Zoning Board of Appeals. They're going to meet Wednesday night, asking them, it's up to them as to whether they want to meet or not. There'll be signs all over the place warning people about asbestos. I'm not sure we have to close off, you know, close the building. I think those employees...
Well, we can't. I mean, first of all, the servers have to stay up, otherwise the village is down.
But we can close the building. We can send people home and decide not to open the building and close it. I think that you know, from what I've heard, people are not, they don't want to be downstairs and they're not happy about being upstairs. And if we're going to notice the public that there's asbestos going on, wouldn't it just be better to close it for at least a day and a half?
I don't have any problem.
No, I think you want to...
What do you think, Bruce?
I mean, as long as the power stays on.
I've been in buildings where they've done asbestos work, and it's fine.
Yeah, I've certainly, in my law office, they did, they put the plastic sheets up, but...
I mean...
You know, I thought most of the employees were okay, you know, working up here. On the other hand, certainly one of the employees said she's, I don't think, coming in for the whole week and will work from home. I think we can talk more about it and decide. I don't care one way or the other.
But they're not going to move to do anything with the asbestos till Wednesday morning. What they'll be doing up until then is enclosing and wrapping and,
right.
You know, I think you know, this is probably the last time we'll convene before this. If we're going to do it, we should decide to do it and let them know. I've heard that, you know, several employees aren't going to come in.
Yeah.
John, what do you think? Is it... close? Well, we put a sign up, but we'll say on the...
There's asbestos remediation going on. Maybe we should close it to the public. What, you know?
Well, we can close it to the public. I'm just wondering if somebody comes in, like, with a death certificate or a burial, whether John would be here.
Asbestos,
I don't know. That's up to you. I assume the funeral directors...
They know how to reach
out. ...have your phone number.
Just based on what I've heard, I would move that we close Town Hall on Wednesday into Thursday when we get the all clear.
Second.
Well, we probably ought to do the whole day Thursday.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
We'll get the all clears probably mid-morning, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock.
Yeah, but to start notifying people, you know. And if we're going to post something on the website, we want to say we're going to be closed Wednesday and Thursday.
And I think that if, you know, the zoning board wants to meet, they'll have to. We could help them find another space, either the village or...
So then I should tell them we are going to be closed and they ought to either cancel the meeting or hold it someplace else.
I think so. There's a possible danger of asbestos to the public and we're posting things. I got a pretty...
I don't think there's any danger, but people are sensitive.
Exactly, exactly.
I don't think there's any danger.
No, I don't think so either, but we're being responsive to people's concerns and sensitivities. So we'll close Town Hall on Wednesday and Thursday?
Yeah.
Okay, great. There we have an open resolution on the floor to accept the bid for removal. Any further discussion?
Well, let me just see. If I had anything else. And then on the heating contract is out to bid. There'll be a walkthrough.
Does this have to do with the removal of the asbestos?
No.
Okay, let's just close this and then we'll come back.
Okay.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So moved.
So, and John, you'll send out an email to the staff that we're going to be closed those 2 days?
We need to do a resolution to that effect?
I don't think so.
Okay.
post on web and signs, and also notice the planning board, I mean, the zoning board.
Now, the courts also, in theory, have something, let's see, John had told me.
You know, we'll give them the option of being here or not. We'll let them know what's going on.
Yeah, Judge Kane is Thursday, 7 to 8.
By then, it should be all clear.
Yeah, right, and people may be coming. It should be all clear.
We'll handle it.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. All right, did you want to...
And there's Thompson Mazzarella, Bruce, on Wednesday, so you'll talk to, cancel that one.
John will notice all the, he handles the facility. He'll notice everyone.
Okay, and Sanchez, 5 to 7.
Thanks. Did you want to continue on with the boiler room, or...
Well, all I wanted to say on the heating part of it, that's out to bid. There's going to be a walkthrough either on the 10th or the 11th. So, Alan, I think you and I ought to be here. I don't know what time, so, because I think Bruce was really the one who, and Bruce, of course, if you want to be here on that walkthrough, I don't know much about that project. But Weston and Sampson will be here and lead it through.
Right, so it looks like we'll have heat this winter.
We should.
More heat and less asbestos.
We should.
Good, thank you.
Or less heat.
Let's think positively.
No, you know, we had some times where the rooms were so friggin' hot.
The proper amount of heat. All right, Rhett, we can move on?
Yeah.
I'll make a motion for Resolution 2015-146, repair of Rhine Cliff Landing Dock Bulkhead. May I have a second?
Second.
This is some damage, repair some damage that we think was caused by the Coast Guard. We are putting a claim in.
Do we put it into our insurance company?
Apparently, we have notified our insurance.
Are they going to go, will they reach out, or?
I don't know. I've been trying to call Brian Moss for the last couple of days, but Rochelle says she's been in contact for months with our insurance company. It's about 11, that Bobby's estimate, and he's probably a little high, is around $11,500. The resolution says that we'll take the money out of Rhine Cliff Dock Improvements capital account, but there may not be enough money there, so I thought the rest of the money ought to come from the Hudson Street capital account, which has money.
As a loan? Are we getting insurance money back?
We may. I have it as a transfer. We can change the resolution to say a loan from. And then
we're anticipating an insurance payout.
Yeah, but there's a $2,500 deductible.
On ours.
What?
On ours, but
on
not,
ours.
Not on the Coast Guard.
They'll subjugate it, won't they go after, I mean...
Before, we've always filed, when we file with the Coast Guard, we get a check.
Right, although I guess we didn't get the full amount. But whatever, we can change, why don't we change the resolution to loan funds?
Why don't we just add a resolve that monies received will be put into the Hudson Street
fine.
Fund?
Why Hudson Street?
Hudson Street was a federal grant to do that whole
ramp.
Right,
the walkway.
And so money's been sitting there, and anything to do with the waterfront that we couldn't find anyplace else, we would take out of Hudson Street.
Okay. Well, let's just leave this, and we'll know that we'll, if we get insurance money in.
Right.
Well, let's add something
memorialize
so it goes
it.
In.
Would you like, I'll make a motion to resolve the resolution. May I have a second?
Second.
I propose that we add a resolve that any monies from the insurance company that come in
or from the Coast Guard
or Coast Guard yeah.
insurance or and or Coast Guard be transferred back into the Rhine Cliff Dock. Well, Hudson
no,
Street,
we're
Hutton Street, we were thinking about closing anyway.
Well, but we haven't closed it yet, so why don't we...
But it's a capital projects line for a project that no longer exists, so we're going to be funding something that we're going to close or divert anyway.
So you put it back into the...
I think we should put it into the waterfront or the docks.
No, that's where I think it would go without.
That's fine. I don't care, as long as it goes someplace.
I'd like to resolve that any funds, John, from insurance payout or Coast Guard be transferred back into the capital funds line for the Rhine Cliff dock improvements.
Okay.
All in favor of the resolution?
Aye.
Any opposed? So moved. Now we have an open resolution to vote on the repair. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? So moved. Thank you. I'll make a motion for resolution 2015-147. 2015-2016 Dutchess County Municipal Consolidation and Shared Service Grant Program application for the evaluation of consolidating our highway maintenance services with the village and I believe and cemetery. May I have a second?
Second.
Bruce?
I went through and did the business case, and this would be a study, a one-year study and possible implementation of consolidating the highway departments, the maintenance departments, and the cemetery. I added cemetery.
Right.
The quote is from the consultant who did the work with Red Hook.
Perfect.
How much it would be, and then the rest of the money is what I figured it would be on our end and the village's from our staff.
Thanks for doing this.
Okay.
Cemetery, what is that? We have one cemetery. Does the village have a cemetery?
It's the concept of a pooled resource that we would end up with, a department, and it makes sense for that to cover the cemetery.
We'd have...
Oh, okay, not to consolidate cemeteries. It's just to consolidate the cemetery employees.
Within rights. Maintenance and the village and town highway department.
Yeah, because what he does is maintenance.
Yeah.
Now, I gather we're also maybe applying for a grant with other towns.
Let's stick to this. I have that as a discussion item. Let's talk about our...
Well, the only thing is, will this take away from our ability to get the other grant?
Who knows? We're not applying for that. Mylan is.
Yeah, okay, we're a beneficiary.
Is there any further discussion? Thanks for doing this. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So moved. Resolution 2015-148, manual check to Green Burial Council for application. May I have a second?
Second.
Does anybody, any discussion? Does anybody know, did Warren approve this? Does anybody know who put this on or how it came about?
Elaine asked.
I think it's called, I read it, and I think we pay $495 this year and then a couple of $100 every year to keep. What?
$295.
Every year thereafter to stay on this list of green burial facilities.
I got this too late to read it. What are the council's standards for natural burial grounds? We have to adhere to it and comply with all requirements, terms, and conditions contained in the standards, including all additions, supplements, and amendments thereto. Is this where Warren had the concern about?
Yeah.
Has he signed off on this?
But I don't know. But the consequences of not complying are simply due to you're not on the list anymore. You stop paying the $295. So
I don't think
there's any consequences other than that.
Where does it say that?
It basically says you're going to be compliant. The only thing we're getting from them is a listing.
Okay.
Yeah, we're not obligated to do anything other than maintain standards, and they'll keep us on the list. We don't maintain the standards, they'll take us off.
Indemnification.
Yeah, nine is removal.
What about seven?
Yeah, it just says we're not going to, if somebody sues us because of how we're running the cemetery, we're not going to involve them.
I would rather Warren, I don't, does anybody have a feeling about this one way or another?
I mean, I think it waited for like.
Yeah, I think it's probably okay, but you want Warren to.
It's up to you guys, I'm not, I just don't feel ready to vote on it. We have an open resolution, all in favor?
Was there a motion?
I did make a motion.
Shall we table it? Anybody have a motion to table it? Anybody want to second my motion to table?
I'll second it. All in favor of tabling?
Aye.
Aye. We also have an open resolution on to cut the green check. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
I thought that's what we tabled.
We've tabled it. Sorry.
I thought you were talking about the next thing.
I know. It's, will you, okay. Resolution 2015-149, cemetery capital expense for natural cemetery markers. May I have a motion?
Motion.
And a second?
Second.
Sorry, I did, got this too late to read it.
So this is what, pay $963 for markers?
Yes. It doesn't say what capital projects it's coming out of.
Well, it's capital project 78.
Do you have your capital projects with you?
It'd be probably cemetery improvements.
Do you have it, or do you want me to go get one?
I think this is it, 78. Yeah, cemetery improvements.
Page 78 is Reinson.
Yeah, go down a little bit, though. Look at the cemetery improvements one. Right there.
Okay, let's make a motion to amend the resolution that the funds be taken out of our capital plan H78-094 cemetery improvements. May I have a second?
Second.
All in favor of amending the resolution to take the $900 out of the H78-079 cemetery improvements capital
aye.
Projects line? Aye. Any opposed?
Aye.
Joe?
Yeah.
Any opposed? So moved to amend the resolution. We have an open resolution on to expense the natural cemetery markers. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? So moved. Thank you. I'm sorry, John, what was the capital projects line? H78-094. Resolution 2015-150, recreation concession stand contract. May I have a motion?
I move.
And a second?
Second.
Helen, you want to?
Well, we talked about this last time. Warren has reviewed the contract. He says it's fine. Basically, this young man, Evan Connolly, will run the concession stand for us.
This is by the pool?
By the pool. he will hire, it'll be run as his operation. The only thing we're doing is allowing him to use the facility, and...
As he provided insurance...
He's got all that's in here. Yes, he has insurance, he has...
But has his certificate of insurance, has it been run by the Spain agents? Are they okay with it? That's what I've done on the asbestos, is their certificate of insurance should be sent to the Spain agency, and they should sign off on whether...
I got a call from them this afternoon.
Spain?
Yes, they're sending it along.
Who's they sending along?
Spain.
They're sending a letter along that says they agree?
Yeah, I think it's probably in my email, or to us before the meeting.
Oh, okay, so the concessionaire has been in contact with Spain?
Yes.
Oh, okay, and they're...
Spain called.
Oh, okay, so we think they may have the right insurance subject to that.
Alan, do you know if they closed with Shelley on the workers' comp thing?
No, I don't know.
Okay. The issue was that Evan didn't have workers' comp, but because he was the sole person, he didn't need it, but if he hires any employees...
He's going to have to have it.
Right, and otherwise, we're going to have to assume that, and... That's a cost to us, so, you know, it's something to monitor.
It can't be that much.
According to the other vendors, this is the slicers and...
Oh, she is right. Okay.
But it has to be looked at in case somebody gets hurt. We don't want to end up having to pay. I guess, Alan, you got to make it clear to him if he has another employee.
Yes, at the moment he doesn't.
Yeah. And we don't get, what do we get, a dollar? Is that the compensation?
Well, yeah, it says here, all required insurance, this is on bottom page four.
There's no slicer on here.
All required insurance must be in effect and continued so during the life of the license is not, in not less than the following amounts. Workman's comp insurance, unlimited, New York State. Disability benefits unlimited and all furnished by the licensee. So,
right.
It's in the contract.
Okay.
Yes, but yeah. That doesn't mean he's actually going to do it.
Well, we'll follow up on it.
You just got to get it if it says it's there.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So moved.
All right.
Thanks. It's good. We'll have a. I like his menu. ferry service as a discussion item?
On Monday, Elaine and I met with the person who made the presentation, and he is very anxious to go ahead. Elaine is very anxious to go ahead with the ferry. Since we have the dock, we might as well try it. I predict it'll end up the same way as the previous ferry, but we'll see. He understands that our dock probably will not go another more than a year or this season. So I would propose that the contract go up till October 15 when we remove the dock. He would like to restrict the use of the dock during certain hours that his boat will be, in theory, discharging and picking up passengers. And I think we did that with the last ferry.
So will that mean that people won't be able to tie up when he's there?
Yeah.
Well, what we did before was we put signs on it. During these hours, it's reserved.
Right. And I would propose that he have that obligation to put the sign.
Will he pay for Warren to write up a contract? Or does he have a contract?
We did not even ask him. You know, we'll ask how much I don't know if we want to ask them.
Is this just a discussion? I mean, are we going to ask for a contract and?
Yes, he knows that in fact Elaine has been in touch with Warren, and clerk's office has provided Warren with the previous contract. I'll give Warren a call and tell him the term. I think on the previous contract, they paid us a nominal amount, $150. I don't know if you want to ask for that, although we could
$150.
$150. It's just a fee.
For use of the dock.
An amount. We can ask him to pay Warren's fee, which I can't imagine could be very much.
What do you think?
If you want.
I'm okay with paying for the contract, you know, a fee equivalent to the Warren's expense.
Okay.
And if they're going to take care of the sign, then that's no expense.
They take care of the sign, and
yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
And the contract should say they pay Warren's fee.
Okay. Good.
And the term of October 15.
Sounds good. Have we ever have any complaints from people in the past when they weren't able to use the dock? What hour?
Yes. Yes, we had.
I remember that.
We had complaints. We also had complaints of the ferry when there were very large pleasure boats, crafts that tied up there and went someplace, and they couldn't get into the dock.
I mean, what will he let us know what hours he's looking for?
Yes,
okay.
We have that list.
So all this will.
It looks like it's 3 days a week, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
For
and
how long each time? Like 15 minutes, half hour at a time?
It doesn't say. I assume he's given us the time of the arrivals of trains.
Yeah.
If we could just get an idea of when he's going to tie up and
why don't we ask him to pay for signage that we put up on the dock so people will know when
I think we
all right we're going to ask him to do the sign and put the sign up himself.
Okay.
Right,
now
so
we'll incur the cost of putting the dock in the water, but since we have the dock anyway, we'll probably get some complaints if we don't put it in the water.
All right, well, let's get a list from him of what hours he's looking for and make sure we talk about it publicly.
Well, it's in the email that Elaine sent around. It's 3 days, as I say. And
sent around what? I didn't get an email.
There is a, I don't know if she sent it. Did she send it then?
No.
It would be on Monday, I think, that he sent his email around. Maybe it just came to me.
Yeah, I don't.
But it's just a time. Now, the train could be late.
Well, let's I'd rather talk about it publicly so the public's aware, and if they want to have any input, it'll be at our next meeting. I didn't receive an email.
Oh, okay. Maybe she did. So we'll have Warren do the contract, and I guess our next meeting is scheduled for.
I think before we do a contract, we should just post the app, you know. I'm concerned that he's going to take up a lot of time at the dock, and I just want the public to know what's going to happen.
Yeah,
does anybody else have any?
It's not a lot of time, Elizabeth. It's 5:35, for example. Now, assume that's the scheduled time of arrival of a train. Train could be late. I assume he's going to stay there
until
the train comes in.
That part's fine. It's, we just don't want him staying there for several hours.
Right.
Right. Come in, wait half an hour till people get on.
We can put that in the contract.
Yeah. That's the other thing that was an issue in the past was people wanting to take the ferry would park in front of the boat ramps where it's no parking during the boating season, and the boaters would go crazy because
we'll make sure that we know that the police will put them on. I'll put them on notice.
Police won't enforce it unless we change the laws.
Change the laws too.
Down nope. There, so it's that's a different issue. But you know, I think maybe we should draw a line or something in the turnaround area. We can talk about that at a different time.
I'll make a note to talk to Pete.
Okay.
But he would like to do it later this month. I don't know if we'll need a special meeting once we have the contract.
We have a meeting on the 22nd, so he should push for that.
Okay. Yeah, that should be sufficient.
Okay. I have a couple of things. I was at the Supervisors and Mayors Association meeting last night. We met at the Beak, and we had a presentation from Habitat for Humanity. They're looking for partnerships with local municipalities, and a perfect fit is open space affordable housing. They are looking to do projects here. I think, you know, at least talk to them, they're a great, you know...
Send me the information, I'll send it out to you.
Yeah, it just seemed like a good idea, even if they can do one or two a year here in Rhinebeck, you know, and they realize we're a rural community, they've been working mostly in Poughkeepsie and this chapter and Beacon, but... We also have a request to film in the cemetery again. Matthew Chamberlain is working on a film being produced by a local, Lucy Barzan Donnelly, and they're interested in filming a funeral scene on Friday 29th at the Rhinebeck Cemetery. Small independent crew with about 35 16-foot trucks, 20 cars, which they'll park elsewhere. Funeral scene should take no more than five, 6 hours, and will require minor set dressing, a pile of dirt, they wanted to dig a hole, but they'll do dirt instead. It's a union shoot, it's DGA, IA, Local 600. Is this anything that we want to... We don't have a policy yet, I don't know that they can pay a fee, it's town property.
We had previously a film shoot...
We had a film shoot...
Last year.
On Wednesday, the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. They were here for about... They went later, they paid us a $1,500 fee, and also covered Gary's... Extra for Gary.
Shouldn't we do the same?
I don't know. You know, I told him that we had a special meeting tonight, I'd bring it up. I think we need a policy in place. It's one scene. What would you like to do?
Oh, I'd like to ask for an honorarium or something.
Yeah, I think we should... Till we have a policy that says otherwise, we have precedent, why don't we continue that precedent?
So a location fee. Gary's our employee, he's on the clock as a salaried employee. The location fee could, you know, cover Gary's salary.
I thought he stayed late.
This will be during normal working hours.
And they're actually going to dig a hole?
They're not going...
They're going to bring dirt in to make it look like they dug a hole. That's what you, I thought you said.
Do you want me to negotiate this to the same one, and if they agree, you will let me... We should have a resolution where you'll let me sign the location, the...
Yeah. They want to do this before the next board meeting?
No, we can take care of it then, they just want a... Our next meeting's on the 22nd, we could formally approve it then. If we can negotiate this, a similar fee and similar terms, we should tell them that we'll do it, and we'll approve it on the 22nd.
We should talk to Gary, though, to tell him we have this. Do you want to talk to him?
We can talk about that, the specifics. I think it's more appropriate for executive session specifics.
Okay.
Of someone's employment terms, I think, were...
Yeah, there was, I'm sure, last time, yeah.
Yeah. I will tell them that we're leaning toward, we'll go for it, we'll formalize it on the 22nd if they comply with everything that we did before. Okay. Bucket truck, I talked to Bill Gallagher last night, the supervisor from Island. They are writing another grant for shared services for a bucket truck. It's a 50-foot bucket truck. Do we want to do that?
I
Yes.
Well, I assume Kathy's in favor of it?
We need it, maintenance needs it too.
Okay.
Yeah, we pay every year a few $1,000 for a bucket truck.
Cherry picker.
Well, I think that we'll still be hiring a subcontractor. I think we don't have enough labor to, you know, we're looking, we subcontract a lot of work. I don't think, Kathy can speak to this, but I'll let him know we're interested.
All right.
Okay. That's all I have. Anything else?
Yes, we tabled the summer soccer program resolution a couple meetings ago. I think Michael DeCole talked to Bruce. I think Bruce's concerns have been resolved. Yes?
Yeah, from what Michael said. I didn't get it from you or Alice. What he told me was that he and Alice met with the Board of Health, and they understand the rules now, and they're going to comply with that. So if they're going to do it that way, I'm fine with it, as long as the Dutch soccer is, you know, we're contracting with them. We're not, it's a contractual expense. They're not employees.
That's right.
So I'm okay with
that. The coaches.
The coaches will be independent contractors, yes.
We're not going to 1099 them. We're going to pay. They're going to give us a purchase order for money that we take
okay.
in for the
yes.
program.
I'll add that to the resolution.
Okay.
All right. So.
We're going to collect the money for them? Why don't they just rent the fields from us and do it?
Well, according to Michael DeCola, the problem was if the pool's involved, they can't do that.
That's
okay.
what the health department
right.
said.
So we're going to do it somehow. I don't know. It's worth trying. And the other thing about it is, you know, if we do it for soccer and it works okay, then we can do it for tennis. We could do it for
right.
for baseball. We can do it for basketball. There's lots of things we could do if we figure out how to make this work. So I'm okay with as long as we follow the rules.
Are they going to provide insurance? How does the insurance
yes.
yeah, they have
work
insurance.
On that? And again, the state agency.
And they're renting the
tell us what insurance they
yeah.
want.
And
will there be a contract there?
Yes.
It's hokey.
So we'll run that by Warren?
Yep. And a contract.
When do they want to start this?
July 20th is the first one. So the week of July 20th, the week of August 10th.
Can we do this at our next meeting with a formal resolution, or do you need it
they
now?
Want to, they want to start recruiting kids.
Can you read the resolution? Is it long?
No, I'll read it. Whereas the Recreation Department wishes to establish a summer soccer program for the weeks of July 20th and August 10th between 10 and 3. Whereas the Recreation Department proposed to cap the program with 36 people and offer it for $175 a week per child, of which 150 would be paid to the organization running the program. Therefore, be it resolved that the proposed summer soccer program is approved. Recreation Department is authorized to take the steps necessary to implement it, including engaging the coaching company. Coaching organization, provided that all health department requirements are met, and that the insurance requirements are met, and that a satisfactory contract is made. How's that?
And insurance coverage, but it sounds like we're doing it. If you say the recreation department wants to do this, and we are the recreation department.
But this is how we've done.
This is a town program.
The tumbling program, for instance, that we do, we engage with people that do that run the program, and basically it occurs under our auspices.
Can we say that they will pay us $900 per week instead of $25 per kid? If all 36 kids don't show up, Alice is still doing all the work, and
I don't think Alice is doing anything. They're gonna recruit.
They're recruiting. What are we doing for the money?
I think what we're doing is we're letting them use our facility.
Aren't we collecting the money and putting it on our website and...
That I'm not sure of.
Yeah, we are.
Okay, so it's going to go
through our website, and we're going to be providing the lifeguards when they're in the pool, and because it's the, whatever you call it, we're going to have an aquatics director there during that time that they're there because of the Board of Health. If it wasn't called a camp, we could do something, but it's called a camp.
No, I think that because the pool's involved.
Actually, it doesn't say camp anywhere. It's a summer rec...
It's pool involvement.
Yeah, but it's different. You know, the way we wanted to do it was, would have worked if they hadn't called it, said to the health department, it's a soccer camp.
Yeah, I would rather they pay this, the weekly fee,
okay,
because we've got to hire these people, we've got to get them there, and it doesn't matter if two kids show up or 36. We still need the staffing.
But it's our lifeguards are on duty.
They're already there.
That's, I don't understand what that $25 is for. That's what I'm trying to say.
Well, they've offered us 25.
Per kid.
Per kid. Capped at 36, which is 900 per week.
Right, and we're not providing any equipment.
Well, it's offsetting our costs, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't think we have any additional costs.
Well, it's all the costs in our budget that aren't covered by camp fees.
No, that's fine, yeah. But there's no specific, I mean, we're not doing
nothing
anything.
Nothing additional.
But, yeah.
I think you have to talk to Warren about whether these really are independent
contractors
or our employees.
I told him they wouldn't be our employees.
Right, but I think you got to ask him. I don't know.
Yeah, basically, I told Warren what we wanted to do. He said there will. He didn't see any problems with finding a way to make this work. Put it that way.
He's ultimately going to do a contract.
Yes.
You know, let him sign off that they're not our employees.
Okay. You want me to put that in the resolution too?
No.
Okay.
Are we amending the resolution to 900 per week?
I'll do it.
Do we have to make a motion to amend the resolution?
I'll tell you what, I'll make a new motion that we can avoid all that. Of which $900 would be paid to the town of Rhinebeck for each week of the program.
So it's going to be $1,800 for us.
Well, if they yeah.
Is that reasonable or too much or?
No, it's not unreasonable. They're going to get $175 a kid, so that's, I mean, once they get past 10 kids, they're there.
But they have to hire more staff because of the Board of Health requirements that they didn't have to do before. That, just to be clear.
So we do have additional costs.
10 to 1 is, no.
No, they do.
They, the soccer people, have to hire additional coaches to get the coverage, the Board of Health required coverage.
So they need three coaches, four coaches.
Yeah.
All right. Want to read it again, or you all?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Anybody else? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So moved.
Thank you.
I'd like to make a motion to go into executive session to discuss the hiring of a particular person.
Okay.
May I have a second?
Second.
Aye.
Okay, thank you. Thanks.